We will discuss the indoor circuit board of a 1-ton mini-split air conditioner from Fujitsu or O-General. First, I'll explain what the fault was, as the unit was completely non-functional, but I've already fixed it and packed it again. Now, we'll open it and take a look at what the issue was, and I'll also explain how it functions. Additionally, I'll guide you on how to repair it if any faults occur in the future. Right now, I'll tell you what the fault was. The issue was that it wasn't turning on at all. Whenever a unit doesn't power on, the first thing I do is check the fuse. So here you can see there's a fuse installed, and it was completely fine. There was no issue with it. However, despite that, the unit was still not turning on. Now, let me share another important point with you. There is another fuse in this unit, but it's hidden, meaning it's not easily visible. A lot of my fellow repair technicians don't understand this point. Here, you can see the connector is attached, and there's a switching relay connected as well. This switching relay is installed because the power supply of this unit first comes to the indoor unit, and when the PCB is turned on, it sends the power supply to the outdoor unit through this switching relay. So the power supply runs from the indoor to the outdoor unit through this relay. Now I'll show you where the second hidden fuse is located. When you open the connector, see I've opened it. This is the relay, but you'll also see a cover next to it. Inside this cover, there is a hidden fuse. Now how do you open it? Look here in this hole, you'll insert a pin or a tester here and press upwards and the cover will pop open. Here, you'll see a fuse inside. This is the fuse. It's connected to the neutral side. If this fuse burns out or goes bad, and if the power supply is incorrectly connected, reversed, the problem becomes worse, and the fuse burns out more quickly. Even if the supply is correctly connected, this fuse can blow due to voltage fluctuations or amperage spikes. So this is the fuse. It works with a maximum of 250 volts and has a 3 ampere capacity. Now, let me give you more information. Here, connected to this same connector, there are many components. First, I'll explain these two wires, because a lot of people get confused when they see so many wires and can't figure out which wires go where. So let me explain it clearly. These two wires are carrying 12 volts. This connector is attached here, and the supply comes from the PCB and turns on this relay. Then, there's the black wire connected to this connector. This wire always carries the phase. The white wire is the neutral, and the blue wire is also connected to it. And further along, the blue wire is connected with the white wire. After that, the red wire is the communication wire. Now, let me explain what to do if you encounter such a problem. First of all, you must check both of these fuses if the unit is completely not turning on. After checking the fuses, the next step is to look at what other issues could arise. Next to the fuse, there is a ZNR. If the voltage goes above 250 volts, the ZNR can short circuit. If it does short out, it will protect the rest of the unit by burning itself out, along with the fuse, or the second fuse connected to the neutral line might blow as well. So both fuses have the potential to burn out. After that, you'll find two capacitors installed here. These capacitors are installed to absorb surge voltages. When surge voltages occur, they absorb them and discharge them into the grounding, which helps to protect the rest of the unit. Next, a line filter is installed here, which is used to reduce voltage spikes. After that, there's an inductor, which is rated at 10 millihenries. The purpose of this inductor is to improve the current flow, ensure it is clean, and eliminate any spikes in the current. After this, the system directly moves into the rectification circuit. In the rectification process, there is a rectifier here, which converts AC to DC. Once it is converted to DC, you'll see a capacitor here. It's rated at 420 volts and 68 microfarads. When DC electricity reaches this point, it is filtered through this capacitor. Now, these voltages go to the switching IC, but along with the switching IC, there is a chopper or ferrite transformer. These two work together to generate the required voltages. Before this, there's another capacitor installed for filtering. Then here, the voltages are converted. DC to DC conversion happens. As you can see, no voltage regulator is used here because the system is small. So, what the company has done is directly take all the required voltages from the chopper itself to power on the PCB, the microcontroller, and other functions. These voltages are directly supplied from the chopper. The rest of the information will be provided in the next video. See you in the next part. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.